sure exactly. I got it off Craigslist. It was pretty sorry shape, and needed quite a few things. Now it has the reverse, it has the electric start, and the rear suspension. And I believe it's a 225cc. So that should make it either a 1985 or a 1986. Because when I look at the parts, they don't make the reverse shift lever for the 84. So a couple of things I've already replaced. New fuel line. I had to put an air filter. There was no air filter on it at all. Put some air in the tires. New front brake pads. Actually, the front has shoes and the rear has pads. There is a mechanically activated caliper in here. It's not a hydraulic caliper like the rear disc brakes of today. It's actually just mechanically operated, kind of similar to the parking brake mechanism you'd see on today's quads. It's got a trailer hitch on the back here, which is awesome because that's mainly the reason we got it. It was missing the air filter on the inside, so I kind of built this little plate to go on the back, and I just basically hung a K&N off the back for now because I figured that's better than nothing. It looks kind of funny on there, but I think it's better than not running an air filter at all. Normally they have a little snorkel that goes up underneath the frame so you can run them pretty deep in water, and the air filter, normally the air intake to the air box is normally up here underneath the neck. So I'd like to get that back someday, since I ever did want to take it out and play around in the creeks and trails and stuff with it. But for now, it's mainly just for working on this little ranch we got here, running the fence line tools and stuff, pulling a little tiny trailer around, maybe hauling a couple loads of some horse manure and stuff like that. And for $100, it runs. Now it has brakes, greased up and fixed all the cables, so they're working again. A couple of things I have left to fix on it. Now the headlight doesn't seem to be working. The bulb is good. I hooked it up to a 12-volt battery and it did come on. The front fork seals, I'm sure those probably need to be done, and this boot right here is pretty much done for. I'm gonna get a new petcock for it. When we first turned the gas on earlier, it was kind of leaking out the overflow, so I suspect it could need a carb kit just so that it doesn't drain all the gas out every time I leave the gas on. I need to check the rear differential fluid. This is a shaft drive, so the rear differential fluid, I imagine that probably needs to be changed. Now this axle right here, I think this axle is bent. You can kind of see it when you're driving. It kind of goes up and down. I might just leave it like that for now, but eventually I'm going to replace this and the bearings inside of here and repair all that. Now the electric start doesn't work. There's no battery in it right now. You can see the battery hole is empty there, so I'd like to get that fixed eventually. I haven't actually tried to start it yet using the battery. I don't know if the starter is busted or if it's just a wiring electronical issue or what. So there you have it. There's my new tri-moto 225. Should be a fun little machine to work with.